What do you do when it's early September and you go to your favorite lake and the guys are telling you that the topwater bite is on fire? Do you go there anticipating that you're going to catch all kinds of big fat fish and stuff and have your big poppers like the Spitting King, the big cavity splash, because you go to lakes that potentially have some really big smallmouth and all of a sudden it just goes, whoa, crash landing? Do you put the boat back on the trailer? Do you complain to your friends that wasn't happening? Here's an option to help you catch more fish on top in those September dog days. What I'll do, I'll go with the KVD splash, a real subtle little walking little bait, but I'll even tone it down to the small one. I call it the baby splash, and it's got that little concave mouth, the small hooks, the little tail feathers. There's opportunities to catch all kinds of fish and all kinds of topwater, but sometimes the conditions are perfect. It's calm, you know, the water temperature is perfect. You know the fish are gonna eat on top and they're not eating it. Vary your approach, change to a smaller bait and fish those same areas with different cadence, fast, slow, slow, pop, you name it. I guarantee you those slight little changes will make a big difference between not catching and catching. So let me show you a couple techniques that I use that you can use in September during those dog days. Those fish are suspended over deep water. Look at that there, all those suspended fish. 8:45 in the morning, suspended fish, there's bait there. They're up high, they're all through the water column here. We're sitting in 21.5 feet of water and the fish are like 10 feet down, 9 feet down, look at them. Those are like predators. Those are those smallmouth that you think, oh, where are they? I know they're smallmouth in the lake. When they suspend like that and they're feeding on smelts or young of the year perch or whatever it is, some fresh hatch of minnows, whatever bait fish they're eating, they can be tough to catch, but you can still catch them if you apply yourself, topwater, drop shot, and everything and anything in between. That little KVD splash, all you gotta do is just work it slow. Slow, it'll do everything else you need to do. Because sometimes those fish, yeah, they'll come up and they'll blast it and they'll get all excited and, you know, maybe there's other fish around, so you get that seagull factor, I call. But sometimes you just have to put it out, let it sit, take your time, and work it with small little pops. Small pop and sit. Because we all love it when you work it fast and the fish are really aggressive and they just smash it and stuff. But I don't know, man, you know, sometimes they can be so stubborn. You see them on the sonar, you see the hooks, you know they're there. And you know you're gonna catch them on top because you've done it before. Your buddies are telling you that these lakes are fantastic for topwater bite, but you can't get them. Those little changes, like putting the small bait on, small pops, will help you catch more fish when those fish are still want to eat and they're still on top, but they just have to be tricked. Right there in September, there's one. Oh boy, hey, what the size of that thing. On a small KVD splash, early in the morning. And you just gotta take your time, fight them out, keep them out of the weed. I got weed in front of me there. I got that small little treble hooks. So you just gotta hope that he's got it good. Fat little piggy. Let's just hope he's got it good. Just take your time. Here he comes up again. Here he comes up. Oh, it's a fat one. Put that net right there. This is when it's crucial here, when they're close. You don't wanna stretch it. Which side are you coming on, boy? This side? Okay, come on this side. He just got in the corner of his mouth. Oh boy. Just the sheer weight of these fish. It's incredible, here he comes. Beautiful fish. See if I can put him into the net. Huh? This is when you don't want to rush it. Just let him pull a bit, let him pull. This is crucial. I use the braid so I can get longer casts with the smaller baits, but you don't have any stretch, so you gotta make sure you got that right rod. And, oh, that's what you use that frable net for, right there. Boy, did he eat that too. He ate it like it's real. Look at that. First thing in the morning, a little topwater splash. And sometimes it's all about the size of the bait. These fish are feeding on these little, small, little crustaceans, whatever, minnows like this. And I'm using that bigger splash and I'm seeing fish rolling on it, not even eating it, just rolling and stuff. So you gotta change that splash. You think sometimes, no, I got one tight on, it's fine. The bigger one, they're aggressive, they're gonna eat it, but they don't. Listen to what the fish want. look at the minnows, see the bait fish, you know, match the hatch. The fly fishermen have it right to a T, and us bass fishermen, we have to adapt the same way, you know, change the size of our baits, colors of the bait, presentation speeds, match whatever the fish want, and you'll catch them too. When life gives you lemons, you make lemonade. When you want to catch them still on top in those dog days of September, consider the Strike King KVD Splash. Little baby bait catches big brown bass.